On completion of this chapter, you will have an understanding of who issues a voyage order, the consequences of a voyage order, the navigational procedures for safe navigation and restrictions applicable for crude oil tankers, the standard routine checks of the vessel's condition, the physical reaction of crude oil during a sea passage, the standard routines for control of the cargo, the special procedures required in order to maintain the quality of certain grades of crude oil. Who issues the voyage order? The voyage order is normally received from the owner or charterer prior to arriving at the loading port in order to ensure sufficient quantity of bunker oil for the laden voyage. What are the consequences of a voyage order for a loaded vessel when the discharge port is not known? If the discharge port is not known prior to departure from the loading port, the consequence may be extra quantity of bunker oil in stock, which may reduce the cargo intake, or the vessel may have to call at a port for bunkers during the voyage. What must the navigating officers of a loaded tanker be particularly aware of, and what basic navigational procedures and restrictions must they follow? As navigating officers, the junior officers must bear in mind the dramatic consequences of a collision or grounding with a laden crude oil carrier. They must be particularly aware of the vulnerable state of their vessel because of its large size and relatively less engine power and maneuverability, and ensure they navigate at a controlled speed and well away from other traffic and coastal hazards. They must at all times be updated on the latest navigational information and warnings, and check if there are special restrictions with regard to how close to shoreline a crude oil tanker is permitted to navigate. What are the vessel maintenance routines that are suitable for the loaded voyage? The vessel's integrity and structural condition needs to be monitored. A system for regular checks of the atmosphere in empty spaces like cofferdams and ballast tanks, as well as checking for water ingress or leakages of any kind, shall be in place, and the result is to be recorded in the deck logbook. The laden voyage is also the time for internal inspection of ballast tanks, and will require full attention with regard to safety in connection with entering enclosed spaces. Ballast tanks are required to be internally inspected annually, and a tank inspection record should be implemented in the vessel's PMS. Know the physical reaction of the cargo. What is the hazard connected with not maintaining the temperature with certain grades of crude oil? Some waxy grades of crude oil may require heating during the laden voyage. This is a demanding task, where the pumpman will be heavily involved in frequent temperature measurements and adjusting the heating. Some charterers require regular information on the cargo temperature and water cut content during the laden voyage. If the temperature is not maintained, there is a hazard that the wax and heavier components will separate out of their suspension in the crude oil and be difficult to pump out later without leaving large residues in the tank bottom. What are the daily routines for control of all normal grades of crude oil cargo in a laden tanker? For most crude oil grades, there is very little physical reaction or change during the laden voyage. Because of the limited space between the liquid surface and the deck, the day and night temperature will cause variation in vapor pressure. This variation will be larger if the liquid surface is low, as in partly filled tanks, and the vapor space is bigger. VOC venting may be required by midday, and a low tank pressure with the risk of air ingress may occur at night, requiring a topping up with inert gas. The pressure is monitored by the duty officer on the bridge. Any venting of VOX or topping up with inert gas must comply with the VOC management plan for the vessel and records should be maintained.